rocking. Welcome to the lab, live from the lab. You already know.
Welcome to the lab, man.
Okay, my drink together. Oh, I'm gonna roll. Let me drop something for him real quick. Hold on. We're gonna ride like this. Yeah. Welcome. Get my levels together. Oh yeah.
Fuck what y'all niggas doing.
Y'all already know, man. Y'all can turn them boring ass podcasts off. We're gonna get rolling over here. Yeah. We gonna get it popping, we gonna get it live, good vibes, yeah, good energy, good people. If you good people, you tune into the right podcast right now. Yeah. Turn me up a little bit.
Nigga, man. What's that?
Let's go.
Ain't no complaints. Rex in the bank.
Okay.
Fuck what you think. We got some rain.
Yeah, man, like I said, man, it's good vibes, good energy. Good people, my boy Tony on the building.
You
already know. It's good life, man. Shout out to everybody that did something great today. Shout out to everybody that did something great yesterday. Shout out to everybody that's going to do something great tomorrow, man. It's going to be you. You feel me? Let's go. Let's go through it, man. We got a couple, you know, the culture. We got some NBA topics. We got everything we're going to get to, man. You already know.
Man, we got some good ones coming up.
You already know. You already.
Yeah. I appreciate all y'all for sending me topics in the DMs, too, man. That's love.
I appreciate that, man. $250,000. We trying to roll like that. Yo, Tonio got the plays coming in. He got the plays coming through. As soon as they said $250,000.
Put that shit on vibrate.
As soon as they said $250,000, it came through. You already know. More. That's my motto for the year, baby. More. We going to turn them up. Let's go.
We need more. Always.
Robbing the bank. Yeah. You already know, man. So. We live from the lab right now, man. It's your boy Taz Crafted, CRFTD. My boy Tony on the building, man. Say what's up to the people.
Man, what's going on? What you putting down, man? You know, Tonio checking in at Tonio Lamar.
Let him know, man. How's the week going, man? How's everything vibing right now?
Man, the week is going great, man. I'm not going to lie to you, man. This week been good, man. I just been, you know, tapped in to myself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Everything around me.
Yeah.
I just been feeling good, been real productive.
That's what I'm saying. Look, you know what I'm saying?
Enjoying keeping everything rolling. Enjoying the moments. Man.
Enjoying life, keeping everything together, man. You know,
yeah,
so
for sure.
I've been on the same wave, man. It's been cool, nothing too crazy, you know. Running up a couple bags, enjoying the family, man. Went to see Super Mario, man. Had to go check out the Super Mario movie with my daughter and the wife, you know what I'm saying? So we pulled up there. Good movie, man. It's a good movie, like nostalgic purposes, you know what I'm saying? Definitely brought back like a lot of memories and everything from playing the video game, you know what I'm saying? And
right.
Like, you know, if you got kids, man, my daughter really enjoyed it, man. It was really, you know, it was a good time. But on the life tip though, like would you really like start analyzing Super Mario? Mm-hmm. Like Super Mario's crazy. Like it's
come
nuts,
on, talk to me.
Like it's crazy. But listen, first of all, Princess Peach is a thotty. Yo, like Princess Peach, like, is,
yeah,
bro, like, first of all, okay, hold on. When we look at my man Bowser, right? So Bowser's the big homie with the, man, like, he owned the land, like, whatever Super Mario Land is, like, that's his kingdom, right?
Okay.
So, like, he run the whole shit, right? Okay. But, like, he just in love with Shorty. So he already got the big castle. He got all the turtles rocking with him. He got, man, he just, like, he chilling. But, like, his only thing is he got to get Princess Peach, right? And she just, man, first of all, brothers, if you got your bag up, brother, and you're doing well in life and you got everything rolling, like, bro, like, just go with somebody that like you, man. Like, don't be out here chasing.
Message.
Don't be out here looking crazy, my brother. Like, if she's not rocking, like, if you got to write love songs, bro, she probably not. That's not it.
Yeah.
That's not it. And then, like, when you look at Super Mario, man, like, are we sure Super Mario want the gay best friend?
Oh, man.
Like, when you really start analyzing Super Mario, bro, like, with the movie, man, like, look, by the end of the movie, Super Mario got superpowers, and the way he was like doing the superpower. Have you seen the movie?
Nah, I haven't. All right,
man, I gotta play a clip or something, bro. Cause like the way Super Mario got the superpowers, I was like, whoa, man.
Yeah, It's funny you said that too, because like the way the world is today,
yeah,
like you saying he's the gay best friend,
is, yeah, man,
like it could be a possibility.
No, he was telling Shorty like, look, man, like that's not the guy for you. Like he got all the money, he got the little turtle joints all around him. Like he not the right one. Like, and he won't even really trying to holler at Princess like that.
Wait, he telling who?
He telling Princess Peach that.
Oh, so he was. But he not really pillow talking browser.
You know what I'm saying? Like, why he out here? Like he was basically like, okay, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, man, it was, you know, like it was, it was hate. Like he was throwing hate at Bowser. Like, yo, how did he get all this money? Like, why is he running the world like that? Like it's like, yo, like Bowser, he Elon Musk, he Jeff Bezos.
Right, right.
Okay. He went, got his hustle up. You know what I mean? If he a little shrewd, that's just him. But at the end of the day, man, I was just like, yo, the message really is, man, if you got your paper up, like, bro, don't go risking that. Like, he risked the whole kingdom for Princess Peach.
Message. Don't go fumbling the bag don't behind that, the woman, man.
Don't do that, man. What else we got popping out here, bro? What else we got rolling? What else we moving to right now, man? We got the NBA playoffs going on. So it's a good playoff.
Did you watch the game last night?
Yeah.
Lakers and the Warriors.
Yeah, Lakers Warriors. That was crazy.
Okay. Yeah.
Like, LeBron the Lakers showed
the GOAT.
Up.
LeBron the GOAT.
GOAT. Sure. For real. For real.
The greatest of all time. We ain't even going to discuss it.
Besides Michael Jordan.
Listen, no. Absolutely not. What has he done besides get six rings that Jordan did?
I mean, that's a long topic. That's a long conversation.
You know what I'm saying? But look, this
have
the point.
Have you gone back and watched videos of Mike playing basketball?
Listen, I get it all, right?
Have you watched the game tape?
But if you're gonna base the argument off of rings,
I'm not.
Bill Russell is the greatest player ever.
I'm not basing it off of rings.
So what are you basing it off?
The eye test. watching Mike play basketball, bro.
Because nobody else in the league was at that level.
Yeah.
LeBron has.
Yeah. True.
It's a nigga on every team that damn near has the skill set, athleticism that Jordan has.
But you can't, like, Jordan's the prototype, so you can't go back on the prototype and look at it and say, oh, just because nobody did that before he did it, like, we can't give him the credit of being, number one, the first one who did it, and number two, like, just being, like, bro, like, if you just watch the eye test, like, I'm not saying longevity-wise, LeBron, but, like, you have to, like, understand that LeBron was able to build off of what Jordan did. He was able to take a lot of lessons that he learned from Jordan. Like, wasn't gambling and drinking his life away at the same time of giving these niggas 50, like Jordan was going out.
Hit me out, though. I get that, right? The eye test is cool, but when we talking about professional basketball players, right, it's like the standard is stats, rings, accomplishments.
I get what you're saying, but like when you get into a certain realm, like you just really can't look at stats and rings to like really determine who's better. Like I get, like there's a certain like level that you gotta get to. Like there's certain people that won't ever be in a conversation because their stats don't measure up and their rings don't measure up. Like you can't even get into the room to have the conversation. But at some point, we just gotta look.
Nah, mm-mm. No.
I
disagree.
Like, no. Have you gone back and watched Jordan? Have you watched Jordan?
I've watched Jordan.
I'll be real with you. I was on the same wave as you, right? Like 100%. And then my pops was like, yo, like, have you seen Jordan play? Because we were here for Jordan's run, right? But we weren't here for Jordan's run.
Listen.
Like, we weren't adults for Jordan's run.
I get that. But also, when you watch those games, don't just look at Jordan. Look at the competition. Like, be for real.
Why you act like there were no athletes in the 90s, bro? There were athletes in the 90s.
Name 10 superstars in the 90s. Now.
I'm not saying necessarily. All right, bro. I can name 10 superstars from the 90s. Karl Malone,
okay.
Keep Olajuwon, Pippen,
okay.
Stockton,
okay.
Sean Kemp.
Okay. We're not keeping count, but that's probably like five.
That's like five. Yeah. We got like Neek.
Then you got Jordan. You got Magic Johnson. You got AI.
That's before Jordan.
You got Shaq.
I mean, Jordan was at a really like interesting like mid time. I'll give you that. That's like the knock that everybody gives it, because it was kind of before AI and Kobe really could have gave him any kind of smoke, and it was after Magic and Bird and like all of them really could have gave him any kind of smoke. So I get what you're saying.
The game is so much more advanced.
I get what you're saying, but it advanced because of him. A lot of it wouldn't, like, the NBA wouldn't be the NBA if it wasn't for Jordan. Like, it wouldn't be the type of money that's in the league right now for it to advance. That's why it advanced, because the type of money that was in it.
But at some point, you have to let that go and say, oh, mind you, he did change the game.
All right, so. But. Hold on, you starting the team. Starting the team, right? You're the GM. Number one draft pick. You got prime LeBron and prime Jordan on the board.
Right.
You drafting Bron.
Absolutely. I can tell you what I was thinking about, because I knew what you was going to ask me. And okay. I can tell you why my answer was so quick. Because LeBron knows how to involve his team more so than Jordan did.
Why you act like Jordan ain't figure out how to win?
He did.
He figured out how to win, he never lost.
LeBron won with less.
Nah. Uh-uh.
Or maybe not one. No. But he got there. No. He got there, though.
Because now you're arguing on both sides of the argument, right?
He got there.
But you're arguing on both sides of the argument.
How?
Because you're saying that today's NBA players are better than the players of yesteryear. So that would automatically say that a Dwayne Wade or a Kyrie Irving is better than a Scottie Pippen or a Dennis Rodman is.
And that's not valid, because
so you take
we
in,
have to break it down to
you taking Scottie over D Wade?
We have to break it down to position.
That's a long ass convo. Yeah, anyway, facts, man, I saw the Golden State Warriors get their ass kicked the other night. I think LeBron, man, like it's amazing. Like him. Like, the longevity of Bron is crazy, bro. All due respect, LeBron is...
Year 20, going crazy.
Like, he's taken the prototype and gone, you know, to the nth power with it, bro. That's crazy to be at this age and be killing like he killing.
Yeah, for sure.
And, man, if AD really do what he's supposed to do out there, like, man, go and stay in for a long series. That's a long series. You got Lakers in this one?
Yeah. All right, of course. I want to see LeBron get another one, because then what people going to say?
It's gonna be tough.
What are they gonna say then?
With another one, I mean, that'd be tough.
What you gonna say then?
Because I mean, at this point, he's done it on the backside of the career. Like this is like Jordan winning ships with the Wizards.
Right. Exactly.
So I mean, you gotta give him credit.
Year 20, my nigga.
You gotta give him credit.
You feel me?
It looked like the Celtics is falling apart. It looked like the Celtics falling apart.
This man, LeBron, is 38 years old. Cuz
is LeBron 38?
38, I believe. You can check, fact check me, but I'm pretty sure that nigga's 38 years old, dog.
All due respect.
Yeah, he got to be 38, because if it's year 20, he got drafted out of high school 18, mm-hmm. 38.
Yeah, that's crazy. Never been done before. I mean, that $1 million on his butt, you know what I'm saying? He's spending it a year. Exactly. Like, money well spent. Money well spent. You think you're going to play with his son?
Yeah, he said that. He said that, like, before he retired, he would play with his son.
Nah, that's what he wanted.
Bronny. Maybe not the youngest one, but Bronny for sure.
I think the youngest one might be the one, though.
Yeah. Because, I mean, Bronny, he going to go wherever he go. He going to stay for a year and then hit the league.
Yeah. Sure. So, you know, one or 2 years, he be out there. Yeah. You know, somebody going to draft Bronny. Like, even if the Lakers don't do it, somebody would do it just for the situation. I think Bron should come and buy the Hornets. I think Bron should come and buy the Hornets from Jordan. Because, you know, on the GM side, Jordan might be the worst owner of all time.
Yeah.
Like, it's something about somebody that, like, got the talent that can't really, like, number one, spot talent or cultivate talent, because, you know, they're so talented that it's, like, second nature to them. Mm-hmm. So they don't have the ability to really, like, bestow that to anybody else. Because, I mean, Jordan really, like, ruined Kwame Brown's career, bro.
Yeah.
Like, took his confidence from him. Like, that's crazy. Like I think Bron as a GM, because it's the same thing I think Kobe would have done for, like, women's basketball.
Mm-hmm.
Like, them, like, on the backside of their career was, I mean, bro, it sky's the limit. And that's dope that they don't have to have, you know what I'm saying? They got something else they can run to. Like, Bron going to be an owner. Bron going to be the first person to really grab a team. And, I mean, that's the syndicate. Cause then he got what's the management company with his boy?
Rich Paul.
Yeah.
What it's called?
Whatever the management man. Yeah, that's so you got the management company managing it, and you got the It's up for Bron. So that's gonna be crazy. Who you got winning the ship this year?
Shit, I want the Lakers to win. I want Bron to get another one, man. I want Bron to keep winning.
Yeah,
I'm a Bron fan. I might be biased. But hey, LeBron, you watch this shit one day, nigga. I fuck with you, my dog.
I'll at it, bro.
For sure.
Come through. We got for some sure. fresh for you, man. Come you know kick saying? It. You know what I'm saying?
Pull up to the lab.
Easy. Man. Come through. Yeah. Come through, pull bro. Up. We got some good tunes over. You know, Brian like the tunes. Yeah.
Yeah. We put you on the track, bro.
Bro, put them on, fair bro. Man. Executive produce something. What? Then executive produced Two Chainz joint.
Oh, for real?
Quote, unquote. Second.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
Ron was like, yo, we're gonna put a couple more records on here called the Deluxe real quick.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. You know?
Well, look, let's switch a little bit real quick.
What's goody? Where we going to?
Let's talk about the black college experience. Especially since I went to NT.
Yeah, shout out to my HU homies, Hampton. You went to Hampton. You know what I'm saying? The real HU, you already know.
You know what I mean? Let's talk about that a little bit.
Okay, let's run through it, man. How was NT? I came out there for a couple of the greatest homecomers on earth. You know what I'm saying? Like,
for sure. It's like that. But, like, even past G-Ho, right? Mm-hmm. Like, NT is just a great-ass school, bro. Like, I give you a little background. Like, I wasn't even about to go to college. I was going to go to a trade school. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because my pops had told me, like, you're not going to the Army. Because he went.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he was hip. He like, you're not going to the Army. So
you do that, so you don't have to go
get
through
a trade.
That.
Yeah, yeah, you better get a trade or something. So, like, probably, like, 2 weeks before, you know, the deadline to let a school know if you're coming or not, I just decided, I was like, man, I'm going to go out of state because like, I had applied to some schools in Virginia. I had a school, a D3 school recruiting me to go hoop and shit. And
mm-hmm.
I was like, man, I'm going to just go out of state and see what it do. And it probably was the best decision I ever made in my life. I'm not going to lie. Like, I done made some lifelong friendships.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just being out there around our people. You know what I mean? Yeah. All the time. Like, I learned so much. You know what I mean? Like, it's way bigger than even just what you see, like the G-Hos and the Aggie Fest.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, the football team was rocking, nigga. Like, we won.
What years were you there?
I got there in 2014.
Okay.
I graduated in 19.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my 5 year folks. You know how that shit be.
Whatever it takes.
You know what I'm saying? You know how that shit be.
Yeah.
But on a serious note though, like man, I learned so much and just like being in that environment around, you know what I'm saying, young black adults who got like the same mindset in a sense, right? The same goals, mm-hmm. the same aspirations, and just tapping into people from everywhere, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cause like I'm from a real small country town, so like I was meeting people from like California.
That was, you know what I'm saying? Like all over the country, right? Yeah.
Like Oregon, like Washington State. Like nigga, when the hell you gonna meet somebody from Washington State?
All the time.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, man, just being in that environment around a bunch of young black professionals, man, like it's the best decision I ever made in my life, and like. That's why I never regret it. Like, besides all the debt and shit, you know what I'm saying? I was out of state, so, you know, they was taxing. But
yeah, I do that.
The experience. But,
I mean, it's going to do that even more at a PWI, so.
Yeah, exactly. And okay. the experience, I never regret. Like, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? I'm forever indebted. You know what I mean? How was your experience at Hampton,
man,
though? Same. I never got up there. I never went up to Hampton
because,
like, I'm from Virginia. I'm from Virginia, so I felt like, man, I don't need to go back to no Virginia school.
HU was different, man. Like, the crazy part about Hampton, and I feel exactly how you feel. Like, man, it's about the care. Like it's literally about, you know, being in an environment in which, like, you genuinely feel like the people there care about you, the staff care about you, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, I got a lot of love in Hampton, man. Like, I was in a leadership institute up there. So, like, a lot of the things that, you know what I'm saying? Like, I learned, like, in terms of, like, how to move, how to negotiate, how to network, how to, you know, just a lot of just life skills I learned just outside of, you know, what you can learn in the classroom there. You know, and I feel like that's a great part of the cultivation process. On the other side, the only, like, one thing I will say, I do wish there was more of, like, a direction and placement process. And I think that's an issue overall for college in general, just in terms of, like, you know, what are you going to do after college? And, you know, definitely if we had more black businesses and things of that nature, I think it would help out a whole lot, you know what I'm saying, in terms of just helping placement after college. But in terms of that process of going through college, man, like, it's nothing like that, bro. Like, it's genuinely, like, I wouldn't trade that college experience for the world. I mean, I was supposed to tour a bunch of colleges. Like, I was supposed to tour, you know, Duke, NC State. I was decent at hooping. Had a couple offers. Had to make a life decision. And I kind of, like, really felt like, professional, like, as a basketball player, won't gonna happen. So, like, I decided kind of early, like, Hampton was one of, like, the schools that was like, look, if you got a certain GPA, but if you got a certain SAT score, which was dope, like, I wasn't great in the classroom, I was okay, but it was like, yo, if you got, a certain SAT score, we'll give you a scholarship. So I went to tour Hampton, and, like, that was the first school I toured and the last school I toured, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, once I stepped on the campus and I saw the vibes and I saw, you know what I'm saying, like, we got a lake right there, it's right on the water. The student center, like, it is a crazy environment. It got this thing called 12 to 2 that, you know what I'm saying, really Monday through Friday. I mean, it's going to be a gathering. It's going to be a party. It's going to be a group event. We're going to have a DJ rolling. We're going to have, you know what I'm saying, like, mm-hmm. like just good energy, mm-hmm. good vibes, good spirit, like, in terms of, you know, just feeding your spirit and your soul to see that many of your people in the same place wanting to do well. And, you know, as I look at it, man, I left college and became an entrepreneur, but genuinely the connections that I made there and the people that I know from school and, you know, what they've gone on to do and what they've gone on to give me access to and what I've gone on to do and been able to give them access to, man, like, it's the name of the game. Like, no matter what, that's why I always say, like, I'll send my daughter to an environment like that.
Yeah.
Just because, I mean.
Oh, 100%.
Getting those 100%. Connections, man, and if you know how to use them.
Yeah.
Like that's the one thing I would say is I, you know, at some point I want to go back or help, you know, just the placement process of, like, mm-hmm. you know, what your major is. Like, I do feel like there are some majors just in college in general that's like, man, that's not a major.
Yeah, for sure. You know what I'm saying? For sure.
Like, come on, man.
For sure.
Like, that was 4 years of nothing.
Take your time picking that major now because you don't want to waste that bread.
Nah, and just have a pathway.
It ain't even that. Dead ass in 2023, listen to me. If you choose to go to college, do your research on whatever major you want to choose and figure out what somebody in that job with that major is making.
Mm-hmm.
It's necessary, you feel me?
And go talk to somebody doing that job.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, don't just read on the internet. Like, really go, you know, get your hands dirty, go network, go talk to somebody doing that actual job and, man, figure that out.
You feel me?
Boy.
Because if you got a vision in your mind of the life you want to live and the major you going after won't provide that life, mm-hmm. you need to do some reevaluation of yourself.
Yeah.
For sure.
Don't waste that time, man.
For real.
Don't waste that time.
You know what I mean? But look, off the serious tip, though, check this out. A&T was rocking.
Yeah. Yeah, we back. You already know.
Uh-huh. I want to give a shout out to all the cool niggas in the world,
bitch, don't
man.
Check me, mm-hmm. bitch, check the air,
you know what I'm saying?
Numbers.
That's the wave, man. Yeah. You can be cool. You ain't got to be no gangster, man. You know what I'm saying? Gangster is being cool.
Talk to him.
I was born in 91. Shout out that boy Larry June, bro.
Yeah.
Real smooth shit.
Yeah, a little orange slice on him.
I mean, this what I ride to when I'm in my 67.
Oh, there you go.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, go talk to him.
Some smooth shit. You know what I'm
saying? Tony, hold up, man.
You know what I'm saying? Catching sunsets. You know what I mean? 6x9s bumping.
Yeah.
Yeah. Them vibes. I feel like I'm dreaming. You hear me? Huh?
Yeah.
91. Hey, look, I just want to say, if you ain't tapped into Larry June, man, tap in.
Tap in strong, for real. Yeah.
Underground hip-hop is winning right now.
We got to get him on the pot. We got to get him on.
For sure.
Put a phone call in.
Hey, Larry, if you tap into this.
Yeah, put a phone call in.
Pull up, my boy. Yeah. I fuck with you. Heavy.
All right, so what we talking about, man? Where we going with this one, man? What's popping? What's on the mind, man? What's on the...
I think we need to go to this 50-50 relationship topic, man. Because that's a big one right now.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Everybody talking relationships. Yeah.
You feel me? Yeah. But yeah. You know what I'm saying?
But everybody talking relationships. So I mean, on the 50-50 side, like what's your vantage point? What's your angle on it, man? How you feel about that?
So I look at it, I'm a realist, right? So I look at it from different perspectives.
Uh-huh.
Right? So I feel like as a man, mm-hmm. right, of course you should want to take care and provide for your woman.
Right.
But at the same time, don't be out here on Instagram and social media and stuff putting forth an image like you got it if you ain't got it like that.
Yeah, it's tough.
You know what I'm saying? Because then you going to make yourself look like a goofy.
Yeah.
When you get a female and she expecting you to take care of her.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And you're not willing to. If you know you're not willing to do that, don't do it. And also, for the females, you know what I mean? Like, if that's what you want, if you want a man to take care of you 100%, mm-hmm. and I'm not just talking about, like, financially. Like, we talking about providing and protecting. You know what I'm saying?
Across
being that
board,
backbone in the family.
Yeah.
Like, living in your true feminine, there are things that you have to do as well.
Yeah.
Like, you can't just sit back and kick it. You know what I'm saying? And, like, if I'm taking care of everything, you know what I mean? And you work, you have a steady income coming in.
Yeah.
Like, you're not just saved, in my opinion, you're not just saving your bread.
Nah.
We going to use the money you making to invest it somewhere else.
Oh, there it is. Talk to him.
We're going to flip the bread that you making. Like,
leadership.
You're not just about to be out here blowing your paychecks and shit because, you know, you ain't got nothing to worry about. Saving it.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, if you're not if you're not a multi-millionaire, what the hell is you saving for? For real, for real.
Mm-hmm.
Cause like you could be invested. If you read the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad, he talk about that shit all the time. Yeah. Like, if you're not up there like that, why you ain't gonna get rich saving. Exactly.
You know?
Yeah. Exactly. So I feel like it's cool. Yeah, as a man, I agree. Take care of your woman. But if you got a woman that's working too, okay, cool. If I'm taking care of you, we flipping your bread.
We gotta be putting
it
somewhere.
I think
at the end of the day, we looking at balance, right? So we're looking to try to find an equilibrium. That's what, you know, and work together too. Like, that's the missing point that I think everybody's not talking about out here, man. Like if you're in a relationship with somebody else and y'all two are not working together, you're doing each other a disservice. At the end of the day, whatever the dynamic might be, like, it has to be a dynamic in which that y'all two will work together. This world, it was built for two people to work together in order for it to really be successful. Mm-hmm. Like, genuinely, man, like, if you out here trying to do it by yourself, like, it's less likely to happen. It's much more likely when you have two people, like, especially with, I mean, inflation, the price of things these days, like, it's genuinely better for you to have two people working together in order for it to be a successful relationship, whatever the dynamic might be.
We
also have to be realistic, ladies, right? So, for the most part, I would say that, you know, 90% of relationships, like, you have to look at it this way, okay? Up front, the woman's going to make a heavy investment to recoup that on the back end. And it takes that being realistic and having faith in a relationship and the fact that we know genuinely women mature faster than men do. Mm-hmm. Ladies, at a younger age, you are going to be more mature. You're probably going to be making more money. You're probably going to be more stable. For sure. You're probably going to be more responsible. You're probably going to be at a stage in which you need to help that significant other that you have get to the point that he needs to be.
For sure. And not to cut your thought off, but mm-hmm. I do want to say this. Ladies, y'all are making more money than majority of the dudes out here. Mm-hmm. Believe that. That's a fact.
There's no more wage gap.
That's a fact.
Wage gap is over.
That shit is over. Women, it's plenty of women out here, black women specifically, because that's who I'm speaking to, that make more money than black men. And that's a fact. You know what I'm saying? So get that out your mind that men, you know what I'm saying, making this big bag, all that. Nah, it's not like that no more. Y'all women done did what y'all supposed to do. Y'all are real life hustlers.
I mean, it's even.
Y'all are
it's,
making more money than a lot of niggas out here.
And it's also, you know, just the fact that that takeoff woman is a lot higher too, in terms of like that takeoff point, like initially where they are. For most guys, you're not really going to get to the financial point that you want to be until you're 35 to 40.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, like, that's generally on the back end when, you know, the pieces come together, you figure out a couple things, you're either able to progress in the things that you learn in the entrepreneurship journey, or you're able to progress in the corporate world. Like, it genuinely takes that amount of time in order for, mm-hmm. you know, just to be able to facilitate you getting to that point in a corporate structure or getting to that point in business. Yep. So, yep. I mean, it's about working together and taking a little bit of patience in order to get to the back end of the journey.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, man, you know, that's all. That's my biggest point is about, you know, just being, like, working together. Because it's crazy, man. You heard about Davis Bridal?
Nah, what happened with Davis Bridal?
Man, Davis Bridal's going out of business.
Word.
It's a wrap.
Word.
Chapter 11, bankruptcy. Like, genuinely, we're at a point now where, like, people aren't getting married at such a rate that the biggest, like, wedding dress, like, marriage company, like, isn't selling wedding dresses.
Damn.
You know, and at the end of the day, damn. Bro, like, I'm not on either side of it. I'm like, man, we got to figure this out. Like, it's crazy. Like, we're not going to work together. Like,
that's
everybody going to do it by themselves.
That's a fact. And I want to say this. Like, if you think about it, right, I'm talking to my brothers and sisters out there. We are the only culture in the world that thinks that we can be oh so independent for the rest of our life.
Yeah, nah, facts.
You know what I'm saying? White people get married early. Mm-hmm. They understand what marriage and finding a person does.
Mm-hmm.
Indians get married early.
That was my, no, and like, let's take it a step further with the Indians. Arranged marriage. Like, at the end of the day, man, it might be time for that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to tell y'all right now, don't think marriage is not the wave. And it's not cool. You feel me?
It's a partnership.
What Drake say? Who the fuck wants to be 70 and alone?
Come on.
That's a fact.
Ain't nobody want to do that.
That's a fact. And not even on the relationship tip of, like, finding somebody who for you and you can marry.
Mm-hmm.
What other cultures understand is that you now have a dual income household if both people are working. You are literally putting yourself in a better financial situation for the rest of your life.
And even if not, it takes two in order to manage a household. Mm-hmm. Like, how can you bring in the income in today's highly, you know, pricey society, mm-hmm. and be able to spend time with the kids and give them the nurturing and be able to take care of a household in that way, man? It take 50-50. Like, at the end of the day, if you got two incomes coming in, like the guys are helping out on the other side too.
Right.
Like, what you need some cleanup? Like, cool. Like, let's, man, it's a partnership, man.
Nah,
just
for sure. Help. That's what it is. That's what I think is being like misconstrued.
Yeah.
Because
it's a fight. It's not supposed
to
be a fight.
A lot of people within our culture forget that marriage is a partnership.
Mm-hmm.
And this 50-50 stigma is, well,
genuinely, like, there's 50-50 doesn't exist in nature. Nowhere mm-hmm. in the world, there's no such thing as a 50-50. Like, even if you look at the yin-yang sign, right, it's not 50-50. Like, there's a big part at the bottom and a little part at the top because, like, 50-50 is impossible.
Right.
There's no way that you'll ever be able to break anything completely accurately down the middle. So mm-hmm. with that, like, it's a partnership. Like, if I'm 60 today and you 40 today, cool. Right. If I'm right. 30 tomorrow exactly. and you 70, yeah, exactly. cool. Like, if you, like...
Mm-hmm.
Like, we just got to make sure we're at 100 and we're rocking. Like, when I'm falling, pick me up. When you fall and I got you. Like, that's the partnership.
Mm-hmm. And for all the women out there that are totally against the 50-50 stigma, I got a question for you. If you don't want to pay for anything and you have a steady source of income, what are you doing with your money?
Man, like, I feel like I need to have, like, people like my moms on the podcast. Let me tell you what my moms told me, right? So, talking to my moms, you know, just about, you know, not like a morbid conversation, but, you know, just arranging things for, like, you know, the future, right? And she's telling me, she's like, listen, so I have an annuity set up. And, like, this annuity, like, I paid for it. Like, you know, she's a teacher. She made, you know, decent money, not crazy. But, like, you know, she was very financially smart by, like, what my pops taught her to do. So she got an annuity. She's like, listen, this annuity pays me X amount a month every month. If I happen to get out of here before your father does, it technically comes to you. But make sure that he gets this every month. My dad doesn't need it. Like, he's totally fine. He's great. Mm-hmm. He'll be good for the rest of his life. He doesn't need it. But she's still, like, no matter what, like, she has certain bills that she took care of. Mm-hmm. She has certain things that she takes care of. She's yep. like, even after I get out of here, yep. if he's still here, like, yep. I want to make sure that you know
mm-hmm.
that mm-hmm. homie, like your mm-hmm. pops, like, make sure that he gets this. Like, make sure yep. that everything I was taking care yep. of is still, like, man, like, they built different from back in the day.
For
bro.
Sure. And the shift is, bro, to the point you was making, like,
yeah.
I feel like at times when that 50-50 conversation comes up, a lot of people resort to back in the day to when women didn't have rights to work. Women couldn't have an income.
Yeah, nah, it's not that. It's
you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's different now. So yeah. it's like, okay. In a real world, right? I'm talking to the women right now. In a real world situation, right? Imagine if you were a man. You're working and providing for your family, and your wife works and makes money. You're taking care of everything financially. You're also providing, mm-hmm. being that security. You're the backbone of the family. What would you want your wife to do with the money? Would you not have questions, or would you not be like, oh, well, you know, you can do this or you can do this? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And don't compare your life to people who are multimillionaires. It's completely different. You know what I'm saying?
Social media has kind of like thrown a loop. Like, it's thrown a wrench in the game that was never there before, man. Like that access and being able to see exactly what's going on, right. and be able to see, like, like, the lack thereof. But let me tell you something, man. Like, jealousy is the thief of joy.
Mm-hmm.
Comparison 100%. Is the thief of joy, man. Like, you can't compare what you got going on to anybody else.
Nah.
Like, that's why, you know, like, it's genuinely, man, like, what you got going is what you got going. How you work out, what you work out is between yep. you and your partner. Like, it's nobody else's business. Like, genuinely, you know, the dynamic of your relationship and how you make that happen. Like, stop talking to your friends about it.
Yep.
Stop talking to your family about it.
Message.
Like, it's between you and your partner. That's how y'all rock out. When y'all show up in public, y'all have smiles on y'all faces and say, hey, we happy and we killing this.
You feel me?
That's what it that, is.
And that's it. And
that's it.
At the stop. End of the day. Like, you know what I'm saying? And that's one of the cons of social media. And
mm-hmm.
it.
Too much access. Is
I can't crazy. Blame. I can't blame nobody for comparing their life to somebody else because it's so easy.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying.
But be happy like, in yours.
Be happy in your own life.
Like if you gonna compare to the bottom side too.
Right.
You know what I'm saying. Like and don't you also, just compare to the top. Like compare to what's below you as well.
You also the big key point that I want to make is you also have to be real with yourself. You have to understand your own situation and your own circumstances.
Yeah.
We not all rich. You feel me? We not all multimillionaires. We don't all got a crazy bag.
Yeah.
Live within your means. Like, who you trying to impress? You know what I'm saying? Like, these motherfuckers you trying to impress is nobody.
And don't even like you.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Don't even care about like, you. It's like, just live within your means and be comfortable within yourself. For real, because, like,
realistic
you'll
balance.
Be lost out here.
Get you a couple
having
nice things.
Balance. You
yeah,
know what
but
I'm
you,
saying?
You don't need too much, man. Like, you realize, like, after you purchase something, like, really sit there and, like, sit with it and find out that, like, man, this purchase didn't feel how I thought it would feel. Mm-hmm. Like, at the end of the day, like, if you have a couple nice things that's dope that you really appreciate, that's why I believe in craftsmanship, man. Like, if you're going to get you something, get you something nice. But at the same time, like, you don't need 100 of them. You don't need 10 nope. of them. You don't need – it's, you know, be realistic, be balanced, and find your happy spot in life. What makes you happy, it might not be what's popular on Instagram right now. And that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. Go with what makes you run. You know?
Feel me? Man. Exactly.
Well, look, man, we live at the lab. We already, you know what I'm saying? We rocking out. Good podcast. You yeah. know what I'm saying? Got some good vibes, good energy.
Yeah.
We appreciate y'all tuning in, man. For if sure. y'all on the YouTube, like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff.
So,
anything, Tonio, you got anything you want?
Yeah, and if you in the Charlotte area, yeah. and you know what I'm saying? We cool like that. I fuck with you. You fuck with me. Pull up.
Yeah, come
you
through.
Know what I mean? We, yeah. we get you on the pod. We talk some shit.
Yeah,
you know
let's
mean?
Get it.
This for the people. You know what I mean? This a podcast for the people, man.
Hit us on the gram. Rock with us, man. Let's go, man. Live from the lab. Y'all already know. Stay crafty. Yeah.
Peace.